March 2025. Two scientists, Corrado Malanga from the University of Pisa and Filippo Buendi from the University of Strathclyde, used synthetic aperture radar to scan the Giza plateau. What they found beneath the Khafre pyramid sent quite shockwaves through the archaeological community. A massive underground structure, multi-level chambers, spiral wells plunging nearly 650 meters deep, a precise geometric layout stretching over 2 kilometers, hidden beneath the desert of sand for thousands of years. But here's what makes it even more mysterious. No one is allowed to excavate it. No teams have been sent in. No headlines made. It's as if the discovery was made and immediately buried again. Now, this isn't the first time that Egypt's past has refused to fit neatly into modern timelines. We have all heard the official story that the pyramids were royal tombs built for powerful pharaohs. It's what we are taught in school, and it seems to make sense. Why else build something so massive? But the truth is far less conclusive. The Great Pyramid of Giza, the most iconic structure on Earth, was found empty. No mummy, no royal sarcophagus, not even a single inscription saying who it was built for. That silence isn't just strange, it's deafening. And it doesn't stop with the Giza pyramid. Many other pyramids across Egypt were discovered completely empty, sealed with no clear purpose, or looted in a way that still leaves experts puzzled. Yet, the Great Pyramid stands apart, undisturbed, unclaimed, and curiously anonymous. Think about it. This civilization spent decades moving over 2 million limestone blocks, placing them with mathematical precision, aligning the entire structure with celestial bodies, and using engineering methods we still can't replicate. Would they really go through all that to bury a single person and then forget to sign their name? Or was the pyramid never meant for death at all? So if the pyramids weren't tombs, then what were they? That question, what were the pyramids really for, has haunted curious minds for decades. But one man wasn't satisfied with the textbook answers. Christopher Dunn, a master of precision engineering, didn't see a tomb when he looked at the Great Pyramid. He saw a machine. In his book, The Giza Power Plant, Dunn made a bold claim. The pyramid was built not to house the dead, but to generate energy. At first, it sounds outrageous, but through an engineer's eye, the design begins to shift. The so-called King's and Queen's Chambers, acoustically tuned. The granite blocks, rich in quartz, a material that reacts under pressure, just like the piezoelectric crystals used in modern electronics. Underneath, flowing water. Inside, narrow shafts that serve no airflow purpose, but may have channeled energy. According to Dunn, the pyramid's geometry acted like a massive tuning fork, capturing subtle vibrations from the earth, amplifying them, and converting them into usable power. Not with wires, but with stone, water, and sound. Mainstream Egyptology dismissed it all. But Dunn wasn't alone for long, because years later, another mind, far more famous, would echo his idea. And that mind was Nikola Tesla, the man who bought us alternating current, wireless transmission, and energy systems that were decades ahead of their time. Tesla believed the Great Pyramid wasn't just a monument. He once said, "If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration." Tesla wasn't chasing fantasy. He was chasing resonance, and he believed electricity could be drawn from the earth and transmitted wirelessly around the world. No wires, no grid. And where did that vision come from? The pyramids. He studied their geometry obsessively. The 51.8 degree slope, the perfect alignment to true north that embedded codes of pi and the golden ratio. To Tesla, it wasn't coincidence. It was a blueprint. In the early 1900s, he tried to replicate it with the Wardenclyffe Tower in New York. It wasn't made of stone, but the concept was the same. A grounded base, a conductive top designed to tap into Earth's energy field. Tesla believed the Earth was a giant battery. And like the pyramids, his tower was built to draw power from Earth. and beam it wirelessly across the planet. But the world wasn't ready. The funding disappeared. The tower was torn down. His notes vanished. And the idea of pyramids as energy machines vanished into silence. Until now. Because if Tesla was right, and if Dunn was right, then the 2025 discovery beneath the Khafre Pyramid might be more than a scientific anomaly. It might be the final piece of puzzle we have been missing. But before we reveal what was found, we need to ask one more thing. A question that's haunted independent researchers for decades. Why has no one excavated beneath the pyramids for over 50 years? You'd expect that after a discovery like this, chambers stretching almost 2 kilometers beneath one of the most iconic monuments on Earth, the global scientific community would leap into action. Teams of archaeologists, geophysicists, and engineers should be lining up to explore, document, and understand what lies beneath. But instead, silence. No excavations. No open access. No public research. In fact, for decades, independent researchers have been quietly denied the permits they need to investigate deeper. Those who brought ground-penetrating radar to the Giza Plateau were turned away. Proposals to scan beneath the Sphinx or the base of pyramids were rejected without much explanation. In 1993, a university team from the United States managed to run seismic tests. What they found were hollow cavities beneath the Sphinx, irregular voids that didn't match any known structure. And just like that, their permit was revoked. Their work stopped. Their access permanently restricted. So what's going on here? Why such tight control? We are told it's about preservation, that digging might damage fragile areas. But radar scanning doesn't harm stone. It doesn't disturb the soil. It only reveals what's already there. And now in 2025, when the most significant underground discovery in Egyptian history is made, we are met with the same response. No excavations, no press release, just quiet dismissal. So how did this scan even happen? Well, according to the paper, the researcher Corrado Melenga and Filippo Biondi weren't part of an official Egyptian archaeological mission. Instead, they use satellite-based synthetic aperture radar, or SAR. Think of it like this. Imagine a camera that doesn't take pictures with light, but with radio waves. These waves can pass through clouds, sand, even solid rock, and bounce back with incredible detail. It's the same tech we use to map planets like Mars or scan the Amazon rainforest for lost cities. But here's what makes SAR special. Instead of one photo, it takes thousands of radar snapshots while the satellite moves. Then using advanced algorithm, it stretches them together to create a high-resolution 3D image of what's beneath the surface. That's how they saw through the Giza Plateau, revealing chambers and structures buried deep underground without ever touching a single stone. SAR technology was originally developed for military and planetary exploration. From thousands of kilometers above the Earth, this radar can penetrate through dry sand and rock, revealing structures that ground-based teams would never be able to see. So that's how they did it. Not by going into the site, but by looking through it from space. A walk around that didn't need boots on the ground. No digging, no permit, just pure data. But here's the twist. Even after this data was published in a peer-reviewed journal, nothing happened. Why? Maybe because this discovery doesn't fit the approved narrative. Maybe because it supports what people like Tesla and Dunn have been saying all along, that the pyramids weren't built with copper tools and guesswork, but with knowledge far beyond what we have been taught. Knowledge of energy, of resonance, of Earth itself. And if that's true, the story we have been told about ancient civilizations, about human progress, about a place in history, isn't just wrong. It's incomplete. And rewriting that story, that's something many institutions still aren't ready for. You know what else is buried and hidden, like the truth under Giza? That subscribe button. So go ahead, dig it up, hit it, and let's keep this excavation going before someone tries to seal it off again. Now, if the pyramids weren't tombs, if they were machines designed to interact with energy, then there's one more question we have to ask. How old are they? Mainstream historians say the Great Pyramid was built around 2500 BC for Pharaoh Khufu, using copper tools, ropes, and sheer manpower. But the evidence doesn't add up. There are no inscriptions, no names, no decorations, just perfect geometry and silence. Compared to other tombs, covered floor to ceiling in carvings and ritual text, the Giza Pyramid feels like it doesn't even belong to the same era. Then there's the Sphinx. Geologist Dr. Robert Sosh found that its erosion wasn't caused by desert winds, but by thousands of years of heavy rainfall. And the last time Egypt had that kind of climate? Well, that was over 10,000 years ago, at the end of the last ice age. That one detail alone pushes these monuments into a timeline long before the first pharaoh even existed. And it's not just Egypt. Around the world, from Peru to Turkey, we find ancient sites with impossible precision, astronomical alignments, and massive stones moved by unknown means. Maybe they weren't isolated civilizations. Maybe they were fragments of a forgotten global culture, one that understood the stars, the Earth's frequency, and how to build in harmony with it. And now back to where it all started. March 2025. The scan beneath the Khafre Pyramid didn't reveal a tomb. It revealed something far more advanced. A hidden complex nearly 2 kilometers wide, 5 multi-level structures, perfectly symmetrical and geometrically aligned. 8 vertical shafts plunging over 648 meters into the earth, each surrounded by spiral walkways, like giant screw carved into stone. And at the very bottom, 2 massive cube-shaped chambers, each one 80 meters long, wide and tall, precision cut, sealed, completely isolated. This wasn't erosion. This wasn't a natural formation. This was intelligent design on a scale we have never seen before. Some researchers believe those shafts acted as energy conduits, channelizing the Earth's natural vibration exactly like Tesla described. Others suggest they were massive resonance chambers built to amplify frequencies using quartz-rich stone and flowing water deep underground. Whatever the function, one thing is clear. This was no tomb. And yet, despite the scale and significance of the discovery, there's still no excavation. So what are we really looking at beneath the Khafre Pyramid? In my view, this isn't just an isolated anomaly. It's a clue, a remnant of a civilization that once connected the world. In our previous videos, we have explored strange global blueprints, from the Nazca lines to Peru, to Olmec heads in Mesoamerica, from the astronomical alignments in Sumer and Egypt, to the spiritual technologies embedded in ancient India. These cultures were separated by oceans, but their knowledge of math, engineering, and the cosmos followed the same blueprint. That's no coincidence. That's a shared legacy. Take the Baghdad Battery, a controversial artifact, yes, but one that clearly demonstrates the possibility of electricity in the ancient world, or the many ancient scriptures across cultures that describe flying machines. The Vimanas in India, the Pushpak Viman in Ramayana, even the Egyptian shining disk of Ra, all hint at a technology that required some form of energy, perhaps electricity. So if Nikola Tesla could wirelessly transmit energy over 100 years ago, only to have his work suppressed by people like Edison and the financial empires of that era, is it really so impossible to imagine that ancient civilizations too could harness and transmit energy wirelessly? Maybe they didn't need power stations. Maybe their world was powered in a way we still don't understand. And maybe something happened. Something catastrophic. A global reset that erased not just cities and people, but entire systems of knowledge. And we see that in every culture. Massive flood, younger dryas, fall of civilizations, rise of new one. Because when we look at all of this, not as isolated wonders, but as pieces of forgotten whole, a very different picture of history begins to emerge. One where ancient peoples weren't primitive, they were advanced. One where the pyramids weren't monuments to the dead, but echoes of a living, thriving science we no longer remember. This is what we do on this channel. We dig deeper, we challenge the textbook, we ask the questions no one else will. Because I don't believe that history is a straight line. I believe it's a cycle. And every now and then, someone uncovers a thread that leads back to something greater. And this discovery beneath the Khafre pyramid, it might be that thread. This is it from my side. This is Harry signing off. Stay curious.